So now in this video, I would like to examine a couple problems where we have to provide the unambiguous IUPAC name, but not given a skeletal drawing. Instead, here we're given a Newman projection. And so just like we converted Newman projections to line angle formulas in previous videos, all right, we're going to take on the eyeball's view of this compound from the right, where this carbon is coming out of the page on the left side of the eyeball. There's a planar bond, and then the back carbon is going into the page, which is to the right of the eyeball. It's best first to convert it to a line angle formula and then to provide an IUPAC name. Remember that anything coming towards the eyeball is a wedge, anything pointed straight up or down is line, and anything oriented away from the eyeball, like the methyl and hydrogen, is a dash. Okay, so on the front carbon, there's a hydrogen directly up. On the back carbon, there's a methyl here going directly down. Those are anti to one another. And then on the front carbon, there's a chlorine that is below this horizontal line. And so it's a wedge, but it's pointed down. This long alkyl chain with a fluoro is also a wedge going towards the eyeball, but it's pointed up or above the horizontal line. And then finally, on the back carbon, there's a methyl group pointed up and away from the eyeball. And there's a hydrogen also on the front carbon pointed down and away from the eyeball. Okay. So what I can do now is simply number this longest chain, right? One at chlorine, two at the carbon in the back, right? Three, four, five. The longest continuous chain of carbons we can get is five. So I'm just going to draw that five-member chain. At carbon five, there's a fluorine. At carbon one, there's a chlorine. The stereochemistry is not relevant in this problem, there are no stereocenters. And then at carbon two, right, there are two methyls here. One that I've shown as a dash and one as a line. So now we have this fictitious planar structure that's easier for us to see. Okay, so we know that the parent name is pentane. We see that at carbon one, right, there's a chlorine. At carbon five, there's a fluorine. So it's five fluoro. And we also have at carbon two, right, a 2,2 dimethyl. Okay, di does not get alphabetized, so now we put these together in alphabetical order. And the overall name is 1-chloro-5-fluoro. Separate the substituents with a dash. Dash 2,2-dimethylpentane. So that is your complete, unambiguous IUPAC name for this compound. So let's do another example. So once again, I'm going to look at this central carbon and the bond that it has with the carbon in the back from the perspective of the eyeball. And this is the line of sight. Or any group that is going towards the eyeball like these are wedged. They're a line if they're planar, and then these methyl groups are going to be dashes. Okay. So constructing that into a line angle formula gives the following. Front carbon is on the left, back carbon is on the right, and on the front carbon there's a methyl group that is straight up. On the back carbon, there's this alkynyl functional group going straight down. And then on the front carbon, there's a propyl group, or excuse me, an ethyl group on the front carbon that's underneath the dashed line, or it's a wedge down, and the propyl is a wedge up. And next, the methyl groups, which are here, are both dashed. On the front carbon, it's dashed down. On the back carbon, it's dashed up. Okay. So for now, we're going to ignore R and S stereochemistry. We will get that in chapter 4 or a later video. Here, I'm only going to worry about providing the IUPAC name with all the correct substituents, and then we'll talk about the double bond. So if you go through and try to find the longest continuous chain here, starting at this end, okay, we can get 8 carbons that way. You could also get 8 this way, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so it looks to me like going towards the left is going to encompass more of the substituents. So the name of this is going to be some sort of oct, not ane, but octene, because we have a double bond, ene, and that double bond is at position 2. Also note, right, that this double bond is trans, or it cannot rotate. To go from carbon 4 to carbon 1, you must cross the pi bond, or that is an E alkene. We also have some substituents, right? We have methyls at position 6, 2 of those, and we have a methyl at position 5. So this is 5, 6, 6 trimethyl. We also have a propyl, right, at position 5. So putting all this together, it's an E alkene, and we're simply going to alphabetize the substituents. One more, we have 1 chloro at position 1. So it's 1 chloro, and we do not alphabetize these subscripts. So next is methyl. It's 5, 6, 6-trimethyl. 5 propyl. 8, 2, ene. So for more practice with nomenclature, and specifically with concepts such as E and Z, and alkene nomenclature, you can visit Unit 1 and Unit 2 of my Orgo 1 course guide at chemguides.com.